Welcome to the last video of number systems and the conversions. In this last video, we'll see how to convert the fractional part of each and every number system to the other number system. There are four number systems which can be converted into each other. We'll see the fractional part conversion of all. The possibilities of conversions are from one number system to all remaining three number systems. This was the conversion summary. If I want to convert from one number system to another number system, let us see the first one, how to convert the fractional part of decimal to the binary. The steps are, we have to multiply the fractional part of the decimal number by the base of the binary number system, that is 2. We have to record the integer part and again multiply the fractional part by 2 for the next iteration in continuous till we get the answer 0 or till the specified number of digit. So let us see the example. For 0.35 into decimal, we have to convert it into equivalent binary. So we can see that 0.35 can be multiplied by 2 for the answer 0.70. So we can say 0.70 can be taken for the next iteration and the integer part is recorded as the first binary digit. 0.70 is multiplied by 2, we get the answer 1.40, but we can write it down as 0.40 with the carry of 1. 0.40 can be taken for the next iteration. 0.40 into 2 again gives me 0.80 as the answer, so the carry is 0. 0.80 into 2 again gives the carry of 1 with the fractional part 0.6, which can be taken for the next iteration. This can be in continuation form till we get the answer 0 or till some decimal points which are mentioned. If you want to take for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 decimal points, 4 decimal points or 3 decimal points, we can stop at that point because this can go till the infinite number. The recording of the number of the carry is from top to bottom. We don't have to take it in the reverse order as in the integer part. We have to take it in from top to bottom. So the answer 0.35 decimal is equivalent to 0.01011 in binary. The next conversion is from decimal to octal. Here we have to multiply the fraction part by the base of octal, which is 8. The same procedure, taking the integer part as the carry for recording the answer and taking the fractional part as the multiplication value for the next iteration. Let us see the example. The decimal number is given as 0.513. We have to convert it into octal. So first conversion 0.513 into 8 gives the value 4.104, which we can write it down as 0.104 with the carry of 4 because we want to record the carry, which is 4, the decimal part, and the fractional part we want to take it as the next iteration multiplicand value. Second step will be 0.104 into 2, which gives 0.832 with the carry of 0. Again taking the fractional part, that is 0.832 into 8, which gives the answer 6.656, which is written as 0.656 with the carry of 6. This also has to be recorded from top to bottom till we get the answer 0 or till the specified bits after the decimal value. So the number 0.513 decimal can be converted into octal by multiplying it by 8, recording the carry or the integer part, taking the fractional part for the next multiplicand value. So 0.513 is equivalent to 0.40651 in octal. Decimal to hexadecimal conversion. Here we'll take the number which is a fractional part of decimal, multiply it by the base of hexadecimal, that is 16. Again record the integer part, take the fractional part for the next multiplication iteration. So 0.565 decimal, if you want to convert it into hexadecimal, we multiply it by 16, we get the answer as 9.04, which can be written as 0.04 with the carry of 9. 0.04 is taken as the next iteration multiplied by 16. The answer will be 0.64. 0.64 again is multiplied by 16 to get the answer 10.24, where 10 is taken as an equivalent hex number, which is A, and 0.24 is again taken for the multiplication in the next iteration. 0.24 multiplied by 16 gets the answer 3.84. The carry is given as 3. 0.84 is taken as the multiplication, multiplied by 16, the answer is 13.44, taking the value 13, which is equivalent to D in the hexadecimal. Again, we record the carries from top to bottom. So 0.565 decimal into hexadecimal will be 9083D in hexadecimal. Next is binary to decimal. In binary to decimal, there can be two ways. Either we multiply the fractional part by the negative powers of n, or divide by the positive powers of n. So if we take the number 0.101, the integer part 0 can be multiplied by 2 raised to 0, or any other digit which is there before the decimal point will be multiplied by 2 raised to 0. So after decimal point, the multiplication factor will become 2 raised to minus 1, 2 raised to minus 2, 2 raised to minus 3, and so on till the last bit of binary. So the value 0.101 is 1 into 2 raised to minus 1, that is 1 into 0.5, 0, we can write it down 0, 1 into 2 raised to minus 3, which is 1 into 0.125. Adding all the numbers, we get the value 0.625. So the binary number 0.101 is equivalent to 0.625 in decimal. This is the next example for the same conversion, binary to decimal. 0.1011, 1 will be multiplied by 2 raised to minus 4, 1 will be multiplied by 2 raised to minus 3, 0 is multiplied by 2 raised to minus 2, and 1 is multiplied by 2 raised to minus 1. Multiplication and addition will give the answer 0.6875 in decimal. Converting binary to octal. The binary digits to octal, we have to take the group of 3, as we know. In the integer part, we take the groups starting from the LSB. Here we'll take the grouping just after the decimal points, moving towards the right hand side. So 0.10010101 will be taken into group of 3 as 100 as the first group, 101 as the second group, 01 and embedded a third 0 will be the third group. So 100 is equivalent to 4, 101 is equivalent to 5, 010 is equivalent to 2. So 0.10010101 binary is equivalent to 0.452 in octal. Now let us see the fractional conversion from binary to hexadecimal. It is same as the conversion from binary to octal. The only difference is, instead of making a group of 3, here we'll make the group of 4, starting from the left hand side. That is, if the number is 1001101, we take the grouping from the left hand side to right hand side after the decimal point, making 1001 as binary equivalent to hex 9, 1101 as 13, which hexadecimal is on D. So the number 0.10010101 in binary is getting converted to 0.9D in hexadecimal. Next is the conversion from octal to decimal. The octal number 0.121, we have to convert it into decimal. Again, we'll multiply by the negative powers of 8, starting from the next digit to decimal point. So we have 0 into 8 raised to 0, which we stop for the integer part, plus 1 into 8 raised to minus 1, plus 2 into 8 raised to minus 2, plus 1 into 8 raised to minus 3, which gives the value 1 into 0.125, 2 into 0.015625, plus 1 into 0.00195312. Adding all the bits, we'll get the answer as 0.1582 in decimal, which is the equivalent of 0.121 octal. Octal to binary, starting from the next digit of the decimal point, from left to right, we'll keep on making the group of 3. If there is a less number than 3, then we'll embed the zeros after the last bit. So 5 is given as 101, 6 is given as 110, 3 is given as 011. So octal number 0.563 is converted into 0.101110011 in binary. Octal to hexadecimal, again there is no direct conversion. We'll follow the same rule, octal to binary grouping of, and then grouping of binary to hexadecimal. So 1, 2, 4 we'll convert it into binary by making a group of 3. 1 will be 001, 2 is 010, and 4 is 100. Regrouping the binary digits in group of 4. So 0010, 1010, and 4 zeros. So 0010 gives the value 2, 1010 gives the value A in hexadecimal. Hence 0.124 into octal is equivalent to 0.2A in hexadecimal. Hexadecimal to decimal, again we'll multiply it by the negative powers of 16, starting from the next bit to the decimal point. So 2 into 16 raised to minus 1, 8 into 16 raised to minus 2, F into 16 raised to minus 3, 5 into 16 raised to minus 4, and C into 16 raised to minus 5. The alphabets which are there, we can convert it into decimal for its equivalent multiplication. So we have F converted to 15 and C converted to 12. So the answer for 0.285C in from hexadecimal to decimal comes up to be approximately 0.15999. The last fractional conversion is from hexadecimal to octal. In hexadecimal to octal conversion, again we have to go through two steps, converting hexadecimal to binary by the group of 4, rearranging or regrouping the binary group of 3 into group of 4 into group of 3 to make a octal number. So for a number 1A6, that is 0.1A6 from hexadecimal into binary, we can make a group of 4, 0 making 4 zeros, 1 making 0001, A is equivalent to 1010, and 6 is equivalent to 0110. This is conversion of hexadecimal to binary by making group of 4. Now regrouping the binary into group of 3 so that we can write down the octal number. So 000, 110, 100, and 110. This will be the regrouping of 4-bit binary into 3-bit binary. Writing the equivalent octal number, 000 is 0, 110 is 6, 100 is 4, 110 is 6. So the hexadecimal number 0.1A6 gets converted to 0.0646 into octal. Thank you for seeing the videos of number systems.